محمد بن عبد الله صلى الله عليه وسلم في التواصل. If you guarantee me six things on your part, I will guarantee you paradise. One, when you speak the truth. Speak the truth, O Muslim. Two, when you make a promise, make sure you do not break the promise. Three, when you are entrusted with something, fulfill that which you are entrusted with. Four, avoid sexual immorality. Five, lower your eyes. Lower your eyes, O Muslim man, for wallahi, hurun een is much better for you. Six, restrain your hands from injustice, for it is darkness on the day of Al-Qandara, the day when every oppressive person will get his right from the oppressor. And there's a beautiful narration that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked his companions, do you know who the penniless is? The penniless? They said, the penniless amongst us, O Prophet of Allah, is the one who neither has money nor commodity. He said, as for the penniless in the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, the one who is from the nation of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, is the one on the day of resurrection that comes with a book of prayer, a lot of prayers, fasting, a lot of fasting, zakat, a lot of zakat, charity. Why? At the same time, he comes with a record full of abuses, defamations, slander, beatings, shedding blood, hurting his brothers and sisters. As a result, the victims will be given from his good deeds. The victims will be given from his good deeds. And if his good deeds are exhausted before he pays the full required amount, then the victim's sins are taken out and placed in his evil record. This is the penniless in the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we know there's a beautiful narration that mentions that when Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, this companion is from among the people of paradise. Now one of the companions was sort of like startled. I want to know this person's actions. Why is he from among the people of paradise? What does he do? How does he sleep? What does he eat? Where does he go? I want to know everything about this person. Because when Muhammad says he's going to be from among the people of paradise, he's going to be from the people of paradise. So this companion started chasing the companion that was informed of paradise. He saw no optional prayer. He saw no optional duties. He saw nothing of him extra. It's a normal Muslim who sleeps, eats, drinks, works, prays like everyone else. So he asked him, because what do you do that makes you so special? He said, I do nothing. But in my heart, I make sure that I have nothing whatsoever evil towards a brother or sister in Islam. There's nothing in my heart except love. Love for my brother and sister in Islam. And I make sure that my brothers and sisters in Islam have the same feeling for me. Allahu Akbar. This person was given paradise for his attribute. Brothers and sisters, it's not hard. Wallahi, it's not hard. It's not hard. And if you want to make it hard, it is up to you. It is up to you. You on your hands have the ability to earn paradise easily. Easy, wallahi, so easy. But it's up to you to really want paradise. The Almighty Lord has blessed us with great blessings, great bounties and favors. وَإِن تَعُدُّوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا. If you try to enumerate, to count all the blessings and favors of Allah, you will never be able to encompass it. You will never be able to count it, no matter how much you count. They're beyond imagination, his blessings. Many of us take it for granted. All of us, just about. All of us. You know, we simply think, that everybody's got these blessings, big deal. So we don't thank Allah for that. Or others say, simply on their tongue, you know, I believe I deserve more than this. They're actually upset with Allah Ta'ala. Because they believe that what they've been given is not enough. They want more and more. And they blame Allah Ta'ala for not giving them more. Look, who cares if your father or your brother or your sister or your cousin or your friend has a mansion and you have it? Who cares? Who cares? It's material of this life. It's not going to benefit you in the hereafter. You know, if he's got a BMW, you have to get a Lamborghini. Big deal. You got a car, take you from A to B. Take you to the mosque and back home. What else do you want? You got legs that Allah blessed you with. What more of a bounty can you ask for? When there are people who are crippled in a walking chair. Or they cannot go anywhere without crutches. When you got Alhamdulillah, feet. You can stand and pray to the Almighty Lord. Now look at those who are higher than you. Look at those who are lower than you. So you can reflect and acknowledge the favors of Allah. Yeah, many people think that they deserve all this. That they have earned it. They have deserved it. And thus that gratitude again is not shown to the Almighty. Allah Ta'ala says, وَاشْكُرُوا لِي وَلَا تَكْفُرُونَ وَاشْكُرُوا لِي وَلَا تَكْفُرُونَ. And show your gratitude to me for the countless favors I have given you. And do not be ungrateful, O slave. Do not be ungrateful, O slave. Show, express with action, with movement, the favors that I have bestowed upon you. By saying, Alhamdulillah. By praying to Allah, by prostrating a prostration of thankfulness. When was the last time you prostrated a thankfulness prostration? When? You should ask yourself, O Muslim, male or female, when was the last time I prostrated a prostration of thankfulness? Was it today? Before I came here? Or was it 10 years ago? If that. If that. That one prostration is an expression of gratitude. You don't have to have wudu for it. Just fall down and prostrate to Him. Whenever glad tidings comes to you, whenever even a calamity befalls you, prostrate to Him, say, Alhamdulillah, oh Allah, it's from you and it's good. This is the way of a Muslim. He shows gratitude internally and externally. Many of us have been brought up in Muslim families. Look at this blessing. In Muslim families. In other words, our youth, throughout our youth, we knew Allah. We never had the misery of living in ignorance or disbelief or wickedness. Is this not a great blessing? Is this not a great blessing? The blessing of Islam, that's one bounty, the greatest bounty on the face of this earth. This one bounty. Do you know what it means? Do you know what the blessing of Islam means? M-E-A-N-S. Do you know what it means? It means that Allah is giving you the path into paradise. Into eternal salvation, bliss, happiness. This is what it means. He has blessed you with this bounty. Inna deena indallahi Islam. Indeed, the religion before Allah is no other than Islam. The path to paradise. Have we thought about this? Have we thanked Allah about this? Have we prostrated to Him day and night saying, thank you, O Lord? Oh no, just another thing in our life. I'm Muslim. I've got to pray today. I've got to fast. I've got to get for Fajr. For Fajr, in this cold, freezing frost. SubhanAllah. This is a sign of denial. Instead, say, Alhamdulillah, I am up. Alhamdulillah, I have the capability of being blessed as a Muslim and the ability to get up for Fajr, which is better than the whole world. Just the two rak'at of Sunnah al-Fajr, wallahi, is better than the whole world and all it contains. But I have to get up for Fajr in this cold, frosty morning. No, O Muslim, no. Thank Allah Ta'ala. Love Allah Ta'ala. Be amongst those who prostrate with easiness on the day of resurrection. Alhamdulillah, Islam, Allah Ta'ala descends His guidance to whom He pleases. Whether you were born and thus raised, create a life as a Muslim, or whether you were born as a Muslim, as every single human is, and then his parents change, convert him from Islam into a devilish religion or concept. But Allah Ta'ala shows signs to people throughout their lives, and these signs can be accepted or rejected by humans. But many are embracing this beautiful path, the path of successfulness, the path of salvation. And tonight, walillahi alhamd, another one accepts Islam. Another human being is saved from eternal darkness into eternal light, from evil to good, from wickedness, mischievousness to righteousness, from kufr to Islam and Iman, from shirk to tawheed. A person, walillah alhamd, tonight will be proclaiming his testification, his declaration of faith here before all of us in front of an en masse of people. So we introduce Siya Sifa, who is from Tonga. Fatafaddal ya akhi al-aziz. Alhamdulillah, we thank the Almighty Lord and Nawada for allowing this beautiful face who is confronting you all, Siya. And we ask the Almighty Lord that He strengthens his faith, given the ability to be one of the soldiers of the Almighty Lord. And indeed, we are in need of soldiers in our today's life. We are in need of desperate soldiers, meaning those who declare La ilaha illallah, thus fulfill the obligations of Islam, to fulfill the five pillars of Islam, understand the pillars of faith, and thus become the servants and slave of no other than Allah. And on the day of resurrection, we ask Him to make us all amongst those who fall in prostration on the day when nothing can avail man except the mercy of the Almighty Lord and His good work in the life of this world. فتفضل يا سيو. Repeat after me. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. I forgot that you're not Arab. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. صلى الله عليه وسلم. بارك الله. I declare that there is no God.
There is no God
worthy of worship.
Worthy of worship.
Except Allah. It's all Arabic. No.
Except Allah.
And I testify that Muhammad.
That Muhammad.
صلى الله عليه وسلم. Peace be upon him.
Peace be upon him.
Is the messenger.
The messenger.
Of Allah.
Of Allah.
بارك الله فيك الدنيا أخي. Give me a hug. You wanna say anything? You wanna talk about anything? You sure? Jazakallah khairan. Allah bless you, inshallah.